Hey guys, welcome back to Kevin Wilson SBC. I'm really excited to share with you a video from a customer and a friend. His name is Don Keller and he has a 2015 Challenger Hellcat. And this car has thoroughly impressed me. And I want to show you some actual track footage. Five passes from this past Saturday at South Carolina Motorplex. And I want to walk you through each pass, including the time slips and the changes we made for each run. Now, there were not big sweeping changes made, but this was the first time testing the Hellcat with the new Menscer shocks and coil springs, all four corners, and the new wave track unit in the rear end. And I'm going to go over some specs of this car, some customizations that have been made to this Challenger, and this car is going to impress you. So let's jump in and let's talk about this 2015 Challenger Hellcat. What are some of the changes Don's made to this car? I'm going to put this up on the screen. So let's walk through this. It's a 2015 Hellcat with a 426 forged bottom end. It's got the 8-speed transmission. It does have the John Reed Menscer shock and spring package all the way around. And I will have John Reed's contact information in the description of this video. Highly, highly recommend if you have a Charger or a Challenger or any really independent rear suspension setup, you definitely should be checking out these Menscer shocks from John Reed. It has a Circle D torque converter. In all of these videos, Don is launching the car in second gear. Second gear, if you look at the ratios of this 8-speed transmission, second gear is already a 3.14:1 ratio. And the Hellcat does still have the 262 rear end. With a 471 first gear and a 262 rear end, The starting line ratio, not counting the torque converter, just the gear ratio is pretty extreme. And you're talking about a car that's right at 4,400 pounds. So when you start putting that kind of starting line gear ratio at 4,400 pounds, and you're going to start breaking stuff. So these launches are all in second gear. Let me just jump in here real quick. I left a very important thing off of this list of modifications. On the back of this Hellcat is the LXLC AAD Performance drag kit. And this is a very impressive rear suspension drag kit addition to this Hellcat. Extremely adjustable, very strong, made a huge difference on the rear end alignment and the performance of this car. So I had to drop in here real quick and just interject this other change that I left off the main list. Like I said, it has a 262 rear gear with the wave track differential. It's 4,400 pounds and all of these runs, it's running 295, 65, 15 drag radials. It does have a 4.5 Whipple on it, and it currently is tuned by Kurt Dusterhoff. And the tune in all five of these runs are the E85 Street tune. There is a hotter tune that we could have went to, but the goal of Saturday was to test the car with the new Menscer shocks. These are brand new drag radials, so we wanted to get the drag radials seated in and broke in. And then towards the end, we wanted to see what we could begin to do. But all of this was done still with the E85 street tune. Like I said, Don has one more tune up that was a little hotter. And I believe the goal is he's going to try to get out to Darlington this Thursday and actually use that tune and maybe open the exhaust up on it a little bit and get a little more after it. But let's take a look now at five runs that we did this past Saturday at South Carolina Motorplex. And what I'll do is I'm gonna go ahead and show you run number one, and then we'll pause and talk through that, and then we'll just keep walking through each run. So let's jump in and let's take a look at run number one. Okay, so here's the time slip for run number one. And as you can see, the car didn't leave extremely hard. Don intentionally did not load the converter that hard. This run was with 19 pounds of air pressure. Remember, this was the first run that we've ever made on the Menscer shocks and the wave track and the new drag radials. So this was just a shakedown run. Let's go out and let's see how the car is going to do and see how it operates. The shock settings that we had for this run are on the rear end. We had the compression from 12 from full tight, and rebound was 5 from full tight. And on the front end, compression was 4 from full tight, and rebound was 12 from full tight. And the car did pretty good. Like I said, Don didn't load the converter very hard. You can hear that in the video. And then just let off the brake and matted it in second gear. And it ran a 132 60 foot with a 578 with a 5 at 122 miles an hour. You also notice in the video, the car was kind of driving left a little bit. Don wasn't lined up exactly straight for this first run. And the car, you got to be careful. You don't want to overcorrect. So Don just kind of kept the car steady and kept it going through the run. Now, for run number two, we left everything the same, but I did tell Don to bring the converter up on it a little bit more. We didn't change air pressure. We didn't make any changes to the shocks. Just wanted to go out and get a second run on the drag radials and really make sure the drag radials were getting broke in. So let's take a look at run number two. Okay, now the interesting thing here is the car slowed down and, you know, nothing really changed other than it had gotten a little warmer. The air did change a little bit and the cool down probably wasn't that long. I believe we had almost a 50 minute cool down on the car, but we weren't discouraged. You can see we went a 136 60 foot. The car still ran a 584 with a 9 at 122 miles an hour. So the miles per hour wasn't that different, but the short times did go down on the car. So at this point, I told Don it's time to make some changes. And what we did on this run is we added a half pound of air pressure. So for run number three, we went up to 19.5 pounds of air in the rear drag radials. And I also tightened the rear shocks compression 2 clicks. So we tightened compression 2 clicks and we loosened the rebound on the front 2 clicks. And the goal was I wanted Don to load the converter a little harder. I wanted to have the compression a little stiffer on the rear to really keep planting that radial. We added a half pound of air and I wanted the front end coming up a little more and a little quicker to help keep that weight on the rear of the car. So let's go take a look at run number 3 and let's see if we can improve on our 60-foot time from run number 1. So right now, run number 1 is what we're trying to beat. So let's take a look at run number 3. Okay, for run number 3, you can see I started using my iPhone on the line, so I had Dad on the GoPro camera. I got my iPhone out, and I started videoing with my iPhone as well, and you got slow motion from both perspectives there. Here's the time slip on run number 3. We went to a 130, 60 foot, with a 574 at 122.95 miles per hour. Guys, please remember, this is a 4,400-pound car launching in second gear, just bringing the idle up to about 1,900 RPMs and just matting it. This is pretty freaking impressive. Now, at this point, the question was, what are we going to change? I loved how the car was launching. I liked the speed of the front end. I liked the fact that the front end stayed up all the way past the 100-foot mark. I was happy with the chassis. So what we did for run number 4 is we added another half pound of air pressure in the rear. So at this point, we're at 20 pounds of air pressure in those radials. And we're going to go out. And I told Don, let's bring the RPMs up to about 2,000 RPMs, and let's hit it. So let's take a look at run number 4.
On that first turn, ladies. Next car coming around is going to be a Dodge Challenger. The SRT. Mind again, stage and lanes are open. Both cycles are running in lane 2. All full 3 cars, full 3 in lane 3. Thank you.
All right, guys, here's the time slip for run number four. We're starting to really cook with some gas now. The car just ran a 129.60 foot, a 572 with a 6 at 123 miles an hour. Okay, now Don is like, he's getting freaking excited. Okay, remember, we're still using the E85 street tune. We haven't went to the hot tune yet, and we didn't go to the hot tune on this day. But I'm just gonna tell you, there's a lot more left in this Hellcat. So what did we do for run number five? This was gonna be our final run of the day. So I told Don, I'm like, hey, let's add another 0.5 pound of air. So now we're gonna be at 20.5 pounds of air pressure in the drag radials. And I said, Don, I want you to bring it up at least to 2,000, 2,100 RPM and mat it. And let's see if we can run another 129.60 foot, and let's see if we can beat the 572. So let's take a look at run number five, the final run of the day, and let's see if we can get a personal best of the day. Okay, here's the time slip for run number five. We matched our 60 foot, we ran another 129.60 foot, and we improved our 330 to a 372 with an 8. The previous run was a 373 with a 2. So you can see Dom was getting at the converter a little harder on the line, around 2,000, 2,100 RPMs, and we ran our personal best ET of a 571 at 123.32 miles an hour, and the car just continued to get better as the day went on. And what you're seeing here is a couple things. You're seeing Don getting more comfortable in the car. The car with the Menscer shocks is like, you could drive it with one hand. It just goes and drives itself. We did the alignment, the front and rear alignment on this car, and we got it set up for our drag racing alignment specs. And Don said with the Menscer shocks and springs and the alignment, he could have driven the car with one finger. And he's like, the car is just a totally different car than it acted with the Viking shocks and springs on the front and rear, which I knew it was going to be a totally different car when we went from Viking to the Menscer shocks, the package from John Reed. But this ET slip is really impressive on the E85 street tune. Hey guys, I really enjoyed working on this Hellcat. I really enjoyed Don, and Don is just a great guy, and he's a drag racer, and he's a good friend. We've gotten to become very good friends over the past year, just working together and helping each other out. And I hope these videos are helping you kind of see the process. This is not a very fast process. There are very incremental changes and very measured changes we're trying to make run between run. And we're trying to leave the track smarter and faster than when we showed up. And at the end of the day, we're trying to do three things. We want to go fast, we want to go straight, and we want to be safe. Have a good day, guys. Do 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 do.